Hello and welcome. I'm Raghav and today I'm going to discuss with you some very frequently asked questions to me related to automation versus manual. So a lot of you have sent me emails and also have written comments and messages to me. And some of the very frequent questions asked to me are, is automation going to replace manual, or is automation testing better than manual or vice versa? And what is the future of automation testing, and what is the future of manual testing, and is automation going to decrease the jobs in the testing industry? So I have categorized all these questions into two basic questions. And the first question is automation better than manual, or manual is better than automation testing? And the second question is automation going to replace manual testing, or automation is going to decrease the jobs in testing industry? So I will first begin with the first question, which is, is automation better than manual testing, or manual is better than automation testing? So I have been in this industry for over 10 years, and I have observed and I have seen and delivered a lot of automation testing projects, and I have also witnessed a lot of manual testing projects. And what I have observed here is, there are times and situations and scenarios where automation testing looks like a better option, and it helps in making the process more efficient, faster, and increasing the quality and the pace. So it looks like a better option. However, there are also times and scenarios where manual testing looks like a better option than automation testing. I will give you a very simple example. Suppose you have to travel from your home to your office, and your office is at a distance of 20 kilometers from your home. Now you have the option to walk to your office. Now if you walk to your office, it will take a lot of time and your energies, and by the time you reach your office, you will hardly be left with any energy to work. So this might not be a very good option. The second option is, you can take your car. So if you take your car, you can reach your office within few minutes, and then you will also have a lot of time and energy to work on your important things in your office. So here, the second option, that is taking your car, looks like a better option. Now take another scenario. You have to go from your home to a market which is very near to your home, and it is at a 5 minutes walking distance from your home. So you can always walk down to the market. It will hardly take you 5 minutes, but you also have the option to take your car. Now if you take your car, the driving time is just 2 minutes. However, there are two signals on the way, two traffic signals, and the average waiting time on every signal is 2 minutes. So the total of 4 minutes is average waiting time on the signals, and 2 minutes is the driving time. So it will in total take you 6 minutes to reach the market if you take your car. Plus, you might have to invest some time in finding a parking place, and you might also have to give the parking fee. So overall, this might not be a better option, and here a better option looks like you should walk down to your market. Now this is what happens in most of the projects and testing projects as well. We always do this analysis. So whenever we have to decide whether to go for automation or not, there are two studies that we do. The first study is called automation feasibility analysis. Now in automation feasibility analysis, we actually check, is the application really feasible for automation? We check, are the resources available? Are the talents available? And all other things. So there is a complete checklist that we go through to decide if we should go for automation or not. And then the second study is ROI, that is return on investment calculation. So here we check the investment that we will make in automating something, including the resources, including the cost, including the time and everything. What is the return we will get out of it after this is done? If the return is positive, then we go for it. If the return is negative, then we might not go for automation. So this is how we decide, and this is how sometimes automation is important, sometimes manual is important, and both of them have their own place and significance. So we cannot say automation is better than manual or vice versa. And I believe that automation should be looked as a helping hand, and all the processes which are highly repetitive, boring, and can be easily delegated to machines or automation systems should get automated, and then the people should be used for more highly creative work. So this is what I believe and my thoughts are. Now if I come to the second question, that is automation going to replace manual testing, or automation is going to cut down on the jobs in testing industry? I will again take an example of the banking sector or the banking industry. Now, if you remember, 10 or 15 years ago, most of the things in banks were manual. So if you have to do any transaction, if you had to withdraw money, deposit money, or do any kind of transfer of funds, you had to go to a bank's branch physically and then do the transaction. And even the bank's employees used to do all the things mostly physically. But now we have all the automated systems in place. You have online banking available. There are lots of mobile apps for banking. So whatever you want to do, whether you want to withdraw money, deposit money, do a funds transfer, anything you can do online. And then there are automated teller machines called ATMs. You can go and withdraw money from there and do a lot of other transactions from there. So you would never have to visit a bank's branch for all these kind of things. So if that is true, ideally, it should decrease the number of jobs in the banking sector. However, if you look at the statistics and if you look at the reports over the last 5 or 10 years, the number of jobs in the banking sector have actually increased. And why is this happening so? So one of the major reasons here is when these highly repetitive and boring work is delegated to machines or automation processes, the people are free to do more creative work, more, they can think about more ideas and they can create more platforms. And that is exactly what has happened in the banks. So if you look at the last 5-10 years, there are a lot of new platforms created in the banks. The banks have taken into consideration a lot of new areas which were not there under the umbrella earlier. And also if you look at financial inclusion, so financial inclusion means the percentage of population in a country that is within a banking system or banking sector or have a bank account. So that was very, very low earlier. But today, with all this focus and new programs and new platforms, the percentage of population in the banking system has increased rapidly. And that is why it is generating lot and lots more jobs than earlier. You can take this example on any industry. For example, the traffic lights. Earlier, there was a traffic policeman who had to stand at a traffic signal and then control the traffic. Today we have traffic lights, so the traffic policeman can do some more important works and then they can create some more platforms. Now this is exactly what will happen in the testing industry as well. So also if you look at the scope and potential of automation, you will see that the scope of or potential of automation has not been realized to the complete or fullest potential as of now. Although we are talking about artificial intelligence and machine learning today, but I believe there is a lot more to be done at a very basic level. I have seen a lot of projects and organizations in India, and I have been to US and seen some organizations and their processes there. And I have seen that some organizations lack even the basic automation, and there is a lots and lots more scope for automation at every level to be done. So this is what my thoughts are about these two questions. I would like to know what do you think, and you can send me your thoughts and comments in the comment section below this video. And if I find something very interesting, I will feature it in the next video. And also, if you have not yet subscribed to this channel, I will request you to subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you can receive new videos from this channel, Automation Step by Step. I will meet you in the next video and episode. Thank you for watching.